Okay, so in this chapter, polygon, we will be discussing quadrilaterals. In polygon, we'll be discussing quadrilaterals. Okay, so see here, in polygon, quadrilateral is one of the polygons. Okay, so we'll be discussing geometric figures. We'll be discussing geometric figures here. A closed geometric figure, that means a closed geometric figure. It is a closed geometric figure. We'll be discussing closed geometric figures. Okay. So polygon is what? It is a closed geometric figure. Okay. And minimum how many sides should be there? Minimum number of sides for a closed polygon. Three must be there. So triangle is the polygon with the minimum number of sides. So triangle is the, at least we require three sides. So geometric figure which is having three or more sides, that is called as polygon. That is called as polygons. So mainly gun, poly means many. Gun, it can be angles or it can be corners. There are many corners. For example, in this case, how many corners are there? Four corners are there, many corners. One, two, three, four, five. Five corners, five interior angles. Similarly here, how many are there? Three corners, three interior angles, and three sides. Okay. So number of sides is same as number of corners or number of interior angles. Number of, or simply we can say number of angles is same as number of sides. So polygon is nothing but a closed geometric figure which is bounded by or which is formed by three or many sides. Okay. Have you seen the polygon with one side or two side? With one side, polygon cannot be formed. With two side even, we cannot form a polygon. It has to be closed geometric figure. We at least require three sides. So minimum of three sides are required to form a polygon. That is a closed geometric figure or a closed geometric shape. Okay. So a plane figure is formed when there are minimum three sides. A closed geometric plane figure is formed when there are minimum at least three sides should be there. At least three sides must be there. Four sides, five sides, six sides, seven sides, as number of sides can be any number. But it must be always greater than or equal to three. Okay. This is clear. Polygon definition. Okay, three-sided polygon is called as triangle, that we have discussed. Three-sided polygon. It is three-sided polygon, we call it as triangle. Three angles are there. And four-sided, it is called as quadrilateral. Four-sided polygon is called as quadrilateral. If it is five-sided, three-sided, four, five. Five-sided polygon is called as penta. Penta is five. Pentagon. Five angles, five corners. Similarly, six-sided is called as hexagon. Seven, hepta. Eight, octa. Nine, nona. Ten, deca. What is 11-sided polygon called? Anyone in class? Ten-sided it is... One minute. Ten-sided polygon. It is called as decagon. Decagon. 12-sided, it is dodecagon. What is 11-sided polygon?
Pentagon.
Okay, have you searched it? 11-sided is called as hendecagon. Okay, it's a Greek word. 11 in Greek, it is hendeca. And deca. Deca is 10 and deca 11. Dodeca 12. 10 plus 2. This is clear? And deca. Have you searched or you knew it?
Searched.
Okay. The person who told better knows that whether searched or knew. Okay. If you knew, it's very good. If you searched, it's still very good. That means being present in class. Okay. So this is clear. So In this chapter, we'll be discussing quadrilateral. That is one of the
polygons. Your voice is not coming.
Okay, is it clear? Okay, do listen here. I'm using Bluetooth headphones, earbuds. So sometimes it happens there is some disturbance. So I reconnected.
Sir, I can't able to listen your voice.
Okay, is it happening with everyone? Anyone who is getting the
clear
voice?
Yes, sir.
Clear voice.
Sir, your voice is clear and your video is already clear.
Okay. So if it's clear from my side, okay? Check once from your side.
Sir, can I rejoin?
Yes, rejoin it. Okay. If you are facing any trouble, you can rejoin it. Okay. You can rejoin it. Okay. So some of the properties of polygon we'll be discussing. For example, this is a polygon. How many sides are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. 6 sides is there. It is hexagon. 6-sided polygon, hexagon. Okay. Now see here. Number of sides, 6. Number of angles, how many? Number of angles, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, when I say number of angles, it means always interior angles. Okay, number of angles, 6. So number of sides in a polygon, number of sides is same as the number of interior angles. Same as the number of angles. Is this clear? And how many corners? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Number of corners, same as number of sides, same as number of angles. And angles are formed on corners only, where two line segments meet. This is clear. Now see here. Polygon can be convex and can be concave. Convex, concave. So when a polygon is said to be convex, when all the interior angles is less than 180 degree. If all the interior angles of a polygon are less than 180 degree, then the polygon is called as convex polygon. Now, when a polygon is said to be concave, when at least means minimum one angle should be greater than 180 degree. If even one angle of a polygon is greater than 180 degree, then such polygon is called as concave polygon. Is this clear? It can be two angles can be more than 180 degree, three angles can be more than 180 degree. That polygon will be called as concave angle. So in a polygon, if even one angle is greater than 180 degree, that such polygon is called as concave polygon. Okay. And in convex polygon, all the angles must be less than 180 degree convex. So difference between convex and concave is clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
The side and angle always equal.
I'll explain it again. Sides are equal. Okay, that also we'll discuss. Okay. Take any polygon. So for example, I'm taking this is one polygon, okay? What is it? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Five sides are there. Okay, so it is pentagon. 5 interior angles. Now check each angle. Is each angle less than 180 degree? Is all the angles less than 180? Sorry. All the angles of this pentagon less than 180 degree? That means this polygon is called as convex polygon. Okay, this is our convex polygon. If all the angles are less than 180 degree. Now, if even one angle, is greater than 180 degree. See, this is less than 180 degree, less than 180 degree, less than 180 degree. But this angle, this is greater than 180 degree. Okay, so at least one angle, even if one angle is 180 degree, then such polygon is called as concave polygon. Okay, or it can be two as well. So here, how many angles are? This angle is greater than 180 degree. This angle is greater than 180 degree. Such polygons are called as concave polygon. So at least one angle must be greater than 180 degree. One angle, two angles, three, depending on the polygon. So even if one angle is greater than 180 degree, that is called as concave polygon. Okay, concave polygon. If all the angles of a polygon are less than 180 degrees, such polygon is called as convex polygon. Okay, this is clear. Now we discuss regular and irregular polygons. What does it mean? So see here. A polygon is having sides as well as angles. See here. Here are the sides equal or all the sides equal? It is a pentagon or all the sides of a pentagon equal? No, they are not equal. Sides, unequal sides are there. Unequal sides. What about angles? Are the angles equal? They are not equal, so unequal angles. So such polygon is called as irregular polygon. Now what does the regular polygon means? Okay, sides.
All the sides and angles equal.
Okay. When all the sides are equal. When all the sides are equal. And all the interior angles are equal. Such polygon is called as regular polygon. This is regular polygon. Okay. Sides are equal, regular polygon. All the interior angles are equal, regular polygon. This is clear. All the sides, all the interior angles must be equal. Okay. All the sides, all the interior angles must be equal. Then such polygon is called as regular polygon. So angles must be equal, all the sides must be equal. Okay. For example, these two sides are equal, but other sides are not equal. Is it a regular or irregular polygon? Is it a regular? Irregular polygon, because all the sides must be equal. In regular polygon, all the sides are equal, all the interior angles are equal. Is this clear? Okay. Is a square a regular polygon?
Sir.
And what about rectangle?
Yes, sir.
What yes. about rectangle?
Irregular.
No,
it's
sir.
Irregular. It's irregular. All the sides are not equal. Only the opposite sides are equal. All the angles are equal and opposite sides are equal. Not all sides are equal. So adjacent sides in a rectangle are not equal. Now, what do you mean by adjacent or consecutive sides? So till now, what we have discussed, definition of polygon we have discussed, in polygons we have discussed different kinds of polygons, triangle, quadrilateral, those or pentagon, depending on the number of sides. Then we discussed the types, convex or concave, regular and irregular. Okay. Now, okay. Now, interior angle, exterior angle, you know. Interior angles, these are the interior angles, and outside they are the exterior angles. Okay, now we discuss a special kind of polygon, that is four-sided. Okay, before that we discuss the sum of the interior angles. Okay, sum of the interior angles we have to discuss. Sum of interior angles means take any polygon. Now, if we add all these angles, what sum of angle will come? What will be the sum of all the interior angles? So there is a formula for this. That is 2n minus 4 into 90 degrees. That means how many right angles? 2n minus 4. And what does n denote? N denotes the number of sides. Okay. Now, if we take triangle, sum of interior angles of a triangle is how much? 180 degree. Now, if you use this formula, formula is 2 and minus 4 into 90 degree. Okay, how many sides? 3 sides. Put n equal to 3. 2 into 3 minus 4 into 90. So 2, 3 is 6. 6 minus 4, 2. 2 into 90, 180 degree. Sum of interior angles of a triangle is 180 degree. Okay, what about quadrilateral? In quadrilateral, 4 sides are there. Take any quadrilateral. Sum of all the interior angles, it will be how much? 2n minus 4 into 90 degree. Okay, n is how much here? 4. So 2 fours are 8 minus 4. 4 into 90 degree. It will be how much? 360 degree. Okay. So see here, 3 sides, 180 degree. 4 sides, 360. So it is increasing by, when side increases by 1, the sum of interior angles increases by 180 degree. 5-sided polygon, pentagon, it will be how much? 2 into 5 minus 4 into 90 degree. So 2, 10. 10 minus 4, how much? 6. 6 into 90 degree. How much? 540 degree. So see here, side increased by 1 and sum increased by 180 degree. Okay. You can see that 180 degree, 360 degree. 540 degree. This is clear. Sum of interior angles of a polygon is 2n minus 4 into 90 degree. 2n minus 4 into 90 degree, where n is the number of sides. You can do one thing here as well. Take 2 outside. It will be n minus 2 into 180 degree. As well, this formula you can do. 2 taking out, multiply with 90, 180. Is this clear? So now we'll be discussing quadrilaterals. So we'll be confined to quadrilaterals in this chapter. So any doubt till now?
Praveen is waiting in the lobby.
No, sir.
No one doubt. Is waiting in the lobby. No one is there in the lobby. I have bypassed the lobby, so no one will wait in lobby. Okay. If you are waiting in the lobby, sir, that no means doubt. Your connection is weak. Okay. So okay, now we'll be moving to quadrilateral. That is 4-sided polygon. Okay. So do pay attention here. Okay, we're discussing the basics. If you understand that, you will always can solve any kind of problem regarding with quadrilateral. So 4-sided polygon, it is called as quad. Quad means 4. So quadrilateral. 4-sided polygon, it is called as quadrilateral. It is having 4 interior angles. So now consider any polygon. Okay, how many vertices? A, B, C, D. 4. Sum of angles we have already discussed. 360 degree. Now, how many vertices? 4. 4 interior angles, 4 sides. The sides are A, B, B, C, C, D, D, A. Or you can say B, A as well. B, A, A, D, D, C, C, D. Okay. These are the sides of the polygon. Okay. Now, adjacent side. Adjacent or consecutive sides or. So which sides are adjacent sides or consecutive sides? So there will be pairs. So adjacent side pairs. AB, adjacent to AB is which are the sides? AB, AD is adjacent to AB as well. BC is always as well adjacent to AB because they are say sharing the common vertex. So AB, BC. This is one pair of adjacent sides. AB, BC. BC, CD, other pair of adjacent side. CD, DA. Again, another pair of adjacent sides. So AB, BC you can write. Or AB, AD or DA. Now, BC, DC. So ABBC or BCAB. ABDA, DAAB. BC, DC, DCBC. So adjacent pair of sides you can take AB, BC. BC, CD. CD, DA. CD, DA. Adjacent pair of sides you can write, which are adjacent to it, just beside to it. AB, its neighbor is BC, its neighbor is AD. BC, its neighbor is AB, its neighbor is CD. They are the adjacent or the consecutive pair of sides. And sir, what are the opposite? Yes?
Sir, what is the meaning of adjacent?
Adjacent, just close to you. Like in class, adjacent to you, someone is sitting next to you. Okay? So, see here, AB, near to it, which side is there? This is near to it. This is as well near to it. So adjacent to AB, which are the side? AB, BC. AB, AD. Adjacent to AB is BC. Adjacent to AB is AD. If I ask you a question, which are the adjacent sides to AB? You will say BC and AD. They are adjacent. They are near to it, neighbor to it. Okay? They are, in mathematics, you can say they are sharing a common vertex. These two sides are sharing a common vertex, B. These two sides are sharing the common vertex, A. They are adjacent sides. The adjacent pairs, one pair ABBC, other pair ABAD. They are the pair of adjacent sides or the consecutive sides. Consecutive sides, next. So 1, 2, 3. Consecutive to A is 2. Consecutive to 2 is 1 and 3. This is clear. Now the opposite. Opposite vertex to A is C. Opposite vertex to B is, okay, adjust opposite sides here to discuss. So opposite sides to AB. Opposite to AB is where? AB, pair of opposite sides. AB, CD. Other pair, BC, AD. So opposite side to AB is CD. Opposite side to BC is AD. This is clear? As well the opposite angles. Angle opposite to A is angle C. Angle opposite to B is angle D. This is clear? Opposite angle to B, angle D. Opposite angle to D, angle B. Any doubt till now? If you have doubt, do ask. So we have discussed adjacent consecutive sides. We have discussed opposite sides. We have discussed adjacent angles. That is adjacent angle to A is B. And D, sir, angle D. Yes?
Sir, can you explain again adjacent angles?
Okay. Adjacent means close to it, near to it. So if we are considering A, closer to it is which? Angle B and D. They are adjacent angles? They are adjacent angles. And what is the opposite angle? Opposite angle to A is angle C.
C.
Okay, if I ask you, what will be the opposite angle to B? Angle opposite to angle B. Angle opposite to angle B?
Angle A, angle C.
Angle D. And what is the angle opposite to angle D?
Angle B.
Angle B. So, they are the pair of opposite angles. Angle B, angle D are the pair of opposite angles. Similarly, angle A and angle C. They are the pair of opposite angles.
Opposite angles.
Okay. Okay. Now, the sides we have discussed. AB, BC, CD, DA. Okay. Diagonals. How diagonals are formed? What is opposite to A? This vertex. C is opposite to A. You should connect these two. A diagonal is formed. It is AC diagonal. Or CA we can say. So this line segment AC, it is called as diagonal of this quadrilateral. So AC is one diagonal. You can write it as AC or CA. Both are same. Okay. And which is the other diagonal? We connect the opposite.
BD and DB.
BD. Okay. BD or DB we can say. Okay. You can say anyway. So AC and BD are the diagonals of this quadrilateral. So in quadrilateral, how many diagonals are there? Two diagonals. In quadrilateral, how many diagonals are there? Two diagonals. This is clear? Two diagonals are there.
Sir, in this chapter, all exercises are coming.
In this chapter, all exercises are coming.
Sir, the next exam now is in January, na?
Okay, that I don't know. I haven't got any information from school. Okay, so these things are clear. Now we discuss the angles. Okay, what is the sum of the quadrilateral? Sum of angles, interior angles of a quadrilateral. Okay, take any quadrilateral. 360 degree. Okay. This is one quadrilateral. A, B, C, D. Four sides are there, four interior angles are there. Okay. Now, sum of interior angles of this quadrilateral. Okay. Okay, there will be no proofs in this chapter. Okay. So proofs won't be coming in exam. Okay. That has been omitted from syllabus. Okay. So for example, question can be prove that the sum of angles of sum of interior angles of a quadrilateral is 360 degrees. So such proof won't be coming, but you must know. Okay. So sum of quadrilateral, interior angles of a quadrilateral is 360 degrees. Okay. So see how to arrive, how to prove that one. So this is one diagonal AC. Now see here, this diagonal divides the quadrilateral in what? This quadrilateral is divided into two parts.
Triangles.
Two triangles. Triangle, first and second. ACD triangle. Triangle ACB. Okay. So how we can prove? Sum of these three angles is how much?
180 degree.
180 degree.
180.
Similarly, sum of these three angles is how much? 180 degree. Okay. Now, if we add all these angles, the sum will be how much?
360 degrees.
And on this side, we can write angle A plus angle B plus angle C plus angle D. This is how much? 360. Okay, how to prove that one? So first, we will be taking first triangle. In triangle ACD. ACD. Okay, so write the angle. Or we can put angle 1, 2, 3. So angle 1 plus angle 2 plus angle 3. How much? 180 degrees. Here I put 4, 5, 6. Similarly in triangle A, B, C. Angle 4, angle 5 plus angle 6. How much? 180 degrees. Okay. Now if I add these two, first and second equations, these are equations. If I add them, what will be there? Angle 1 plus angle 2 plus angle 2, angle 3 plus angle 4 plus angle 5 plus angle 6. This will be how much? 180 plus 180, 360 degrees. So left hand side, we have the angles. On the right hand side, we have 360 degrees. Now see here, angle 1 plus angle 5. This is what? Angle A. This is angle A. Angle 1 plus angle 5. This is angle A. Okay. Similarly, angle 2 and 4. 2 and 4. It is angle C plus angle C. Okay. Angle 3 is what? Angle D. Angle 6 is angle B. Or more in detail you want to write, then write angle B is what? A, angle A, B, C. Okay. This is what? 360 degree. Now this is what? Angle A plus angle B plus angle C plus angle D is how much? 360 degree. These are some of the interior angles. We have proved in quadrilateral. Have you understood this one?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So always remember, sum of the interior angles of a quadrilateral is how much? 360 degrees. In triangle, it is 180 degree. Double of that, it will be in quadrilateral, 360 degree. And in pentagon, add 180 degree to that. Okay. So sum of interior angles is 360 degree. Now, if three angles are provided, the fourth angle you can calculate. Or if it is said in a regular polygon, you can calculate the interior angle of a regular quadrilateral. So regular quadrilateral will be what? If a quadrilateral is regular, it will be called as special name it is having. If a quadrilateral is regular, then that polygon is called as, that quadrilateral is called as, anyone in class, if a quadrilateral is regular, it is called what? All the angles are equal, interior angles.
All angles are equal.
All sides are equal.
It will be
square. All angles and sides are equal.
Yes, it is square. It is a square. Okay. Okay, let's do the exercise now. Okay, a quadrilateral is a polygon with how many sides? How many sides
four
a quadrilateral
sides.
Has?
Four sides.
Okay.
Four.
And how many angles? How many angles?
Four.
When angles?
Four.
Okay. Sum of all the angles of a quadrilateral equals to how many right angles?
Four right angles.
Four into 90 degrees. Right angles. Four right angles. Okay. So in the adjoining figure, okay, that will be doing afterwards. Second question, you try to do it yourself and we'll discuss afterwards. Okay. Now, if three angles of a quadrilateral are given, that is, one angle is 115 degrees, 78 and 84. 78 degree, 84 degree. We have to find the fourth angle. A, B, C, D. How you can calculate the fourth angle?
So we will add the three angles and minus
then
it.
We will add the, all the three sides minus 360.
Yes, that we'll be doing. So how we'll be doing?
Answer
so
is 360.
Answer is 360. But
so take angle C as X.
So first you have to write one statement. The sum of interior angles of a quadrilateral equal to 360 degree. Sum of interior angles of a quadrilateral, please mute yourself, equal to 360 degree. Okay. Now on left hand side, you will write all the angles. Okay. Let this angle we have to calculate. Angle A, you can do it like this, or you can put that that X angle which you have to calculate as X as well. Okay. Angle B plus angle C plus angle D. How much? 360 degree. Now put all the angles. You can take any angle as A, 78 degree plus 84 degree plus angle C plus 115 degree, 360 degree. Add these angles.
Sir, we have to draw the figure.
No need of drawing. So it's fine. Or you can do like this, or you can do like this. Let the fourth angle be as X. Okay. Then you write 78 degree plus 115 degree plus 84 degree. Plus X equal to 360 degree. Now calculate X. If you don't do the figure, you can do it like this.
The questions. Okay. So question number first you have to do.
Question number first, do it in book. Okay. Second question, do in notebook. Third question, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, there we have to do in notebook. Okay. First.
Okay, sir.
Okay. So this is clear.
So second also we have to do in notebook.
Do in notebook once you write all this. Okay, it's good. Okay, so see here you can do two ways. Either draw the diagram, put any angle. Okay, let angle be this. Then sum of interior angles equal to of a quadrilateral equal to 360 degree. This step you must write. Okay, then sum of the angles like this. Or you can do like this. Let the fourth angle be X. If you don't draw the figure, you can write let the fourth angle be X. Sum of interior angles of a quadrilateral equal to 360 degree. Then write 78 degree plus 115 plus 84 degree plus X equal to 360 degree. Calculate the value of X. Okay.
So then write.
360 minus 277.
Okay, do that. The fourth
question.
No need of writing question. Never write questions. Okay. You have the book. Okay.
Can you say which questions we have to do in notebook? Sir, please
you
tell again.
All the questions. Okay. Leaving first, you have to do all the questions. Okay.
Sir, we have to write the questions.
No, don't write questions. Don't write questions. Okay. Try to do third question. Then we'll do fourth question tomorrow. Okay. This is the issue. Okay, see here. Diagram is not compulsory. You can solve the question without drawing the diagram as well. You can, if you want, you can do the diagram or without the diagram as well. Okay. So again, I take 1 minute. Okay. Two methods I'll tell, first and second. Okay. In first method, draw the diagram. Any diagram you draw, then mark the three angles. Fourth angle, no need of marking. You can take as X. Then write sum of all the interior angles equal to 360 degree. Then, like A, B, C, D, you mark. And this time, D we do not know. So angle A plus angle B plus angle C plus angle D equal to 360 degree. Value of A is given, put here. Value of B is given, put here. Value of C is given, and calculate angle D. At tries, the fourth angle is this much. Okay, this is one way. The second way, let the fourth angle be X. Okay, sum of interior angles of a quadrilateral equal to 360 degree. Then write like 77 degree, 105 degree plus 34 degree plus X equal to 360 degree. And then calculate the value of X. At last, write the fourth angle is equal to 360 degree. Okay, for this, you can check the example. Examples are given.
Time over.
Okay, time over. Okay, those two examples are given. You can go through them as well. Okay.
Sir, attendance.
Can I leave?
Yes, you can leave. Okay, so try to do third question only.
Thank you, sir. Very good, sir.
Class. Sir, third question. Thank you, sir.
Okay, second and third.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Ratio based, we'll discuss in class, okay? Rest question we'll do in class tomorrow, okay? This is very interesting and very easy as well, okay?
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you all.
Thank you, sir.
And yes, those who haven't submitted the work of mathematics, try to complete this week and try to submit, okay? And one more student, I have approached. Ronak, your approach. I will try to solve your question. I will tell you on WhatsApp, okay?